Get in the pickup truck, start riding. Let's go. I'll show you the difference. You know, I'll show you the washouts. I'll show you where your cane or your crop is going to be better over 5 years compared to just that immediate result of, hey, maybe 1 year the crop may look a little bit better, but let's look at the end result. Let's look at the total dollars of per acre that you may lose because your soil's not healthy, or you may not be keeping your residue, or something like that. It's just, there's a very big picture around soil health. There's not just one thing that can say, you know, and it's gradual. It is gradual. It's a process for sure.
I have tremendously healthy soil. I went from 0.5% of organic matter to an average of about 2.8, and in some places I'm up to 3.7 organic matter. And in the South, that is huge. My tillage neighbors are lucky if they have 0.5% organic matter. And that is the life of the soil. And so that, I'm extremely proud about.
I've been working with Robbie for almost 2 years. We learn from each other. He is definitely a soil health and cover crop guru for East Carroll Parish. He's been doing this for almost 20 years. A lot of his neighbors think he's crazy, but it works, and he's proved that it works. And he's steadily learning throughout the years things that that are working for him and things that aren't working for him. And so he continues to improve and learn each year through trial and error. You know, and like I said, he's been doing this for 20 years. So it's not a, you know, just one thing fixes everything. All, you know.
NRCS has meant a lot. We have formed a partnership. We're both learning together on this. They're kind of new at it, and I'm kind of new at it. In Louisiana, let me put it that way. Okay, I'm sure in the Midwest where they are been doing it long, long time, but here in Louisiana, we're still in the learning process because there's so many, many people that are not doing it. But yeah, it's a great relationship. I've gotten a lot of help out of them, and our partnership is great.
With NRCS, you know, we've, I guess, identified some practices on our farm that looked like it was helping us be more efficient. Kind of pointed those out and worked with them to develop a showing that it's a good practice that other farmers can do, and they could cost share with other farmers to try and convince them to change some of their practices into these more sustainable practices.
If you're a good stewardship of the soil and you protect the soil, and they always say if you build a house, the wildlife will come. Well, if you hold the water out here, the wildlife will come. They use water as a plow, and Jeff and them does a lot of no-till, where when they drain these ponds, they just come back in and then they plant their rice or whatever crop they're gonna. So they're not out there tilling the soil all the time, degrading the organic matter, and then letting the sediment run into the neighboring streams.
A lot of the practices here on the farm involving their rotation between crawfish and rice, and incorporating no-till, the non-tillage aspect of production, as well as trying to improve soil health through various cover crops, radishes and rye and things of this nature, are things that are not common in the rice industry so much, but often to the practices that are begun here on this farm. Some of those practices ultimately make it to a wider audience, into wider practice within the rice community.
Too many people that you talk to where they've implemented these systems, they're seeing better yields with less inputs of labor, some fertilizer, et cetera. So there's no way to walk it back, and we find that the folks that have taken it to heart and have done this more than a couple of years, where they're actually starting to see the derived benefits from it, they're not backing up. They're not going the opposite way. So that's the biggest thing in my mind that tells me if people that have tried it long enough to get it to work and it's working for them.
Where do you start with soil health? I mean, what's difficult with soil health to me is you don't see it initially. It's not immediate, but when you come over here and you've been doing it for 3 years and you just kind of, the biggest thing about soil health for me is sometimes you just got to forget about it. Keep it simple. I say kiss it. Keep it simple, stupid. Kiss it. Just kiss it, you know, and let it work.